any unit that can respond is going to be in reference to a drowning.
Empty chairs, still water. The pool at Falcon Point apartments closed.
An 8-year-old who is drowning.
Less than 24 hours after an 8-year-old boy stopped breathing at the pool.
He is out of the pool at this time. Someone's giving him CPR.
People that were here and first responders.
Fire and EMS on route.
Gave the child CPR. We don't know how he's doing now, but the fire department's water rescue team says performing the life-saving measure makes a difference.
The sooner you start doing compressions, the better it is.
Captain Mark Malachek says his team responds to pools, lakes, even high flood waters.
Anything water-related, we do it. Flooding is what my experience is the most we've gone on. Probably pools the next.
They're gearing up for another kind of busy season. More bodies in the water means a higher chance of something going wrong. The Winston-Salem Parks and Recreation Department is working to prevent that.
There's always close calls when kids like to take off their life jackets.
One of the biggest preventative measures they take
usually doesn't end with any tragedies
are these wristbands.
It's been going on since the fatality at Kimberly Park. There was a drowning about 10 years ago.
To get one of these, you have to take a test, you have to swim 25 yards, and tread the water for a minute.
Kids don't really understand, like, how deep the pool can get, or how, like, if they just get tired from swimming, and they all think that they can swim when in reality they can't.
But kids aren't the only people who don't know better. Parents need to pay attention too.
We're here to guard lives, not babysit your children. Like, if you bring your kids to the pool, make sure you're watching them.